Number 15. Roger Rabbit's cartoon spin.
Yeah, you know how hindsight is 20/20. How last time I said this.
And this has the worst cue area ever.
I was an idiot.
Not only because I was judging it based on some rather unfortunate circumstances, like waiting more than the posted wait time with people who lack all knowledge of what a bar of soap is, but due to that alone, I dismissed the entire ride.
So yeah, my last outing could have been a top 25. Knowing me, I would have put it at 25, but whatever. What made me come around, other than growing out of my young and stupids?
Oddly or fittingly enough, it all started with the queue. Once I started dating someone who knew a thing or two about artistic merit...
You're welcome.
Thank you, dear. I began to appreciate it. Now, I cannot imagine how this ride could have worked without it. Like any good ride nowadays, the queue should act as a prologue to the experience. And this is a beautiful setup, with mere snapshots of Toontown rendered by nothing short of the most brilliant Imagineering techniques. You not only feel like you're in the world of the movie, you're part of the story.
However, the ride is a 180 degree contrast, or 360 degree contrast.
Now, normally I would file something like this under tonal whiplash, but that's sort of the point. The maniacal world of the Toons is nothing but a series of tonal whiplashes. And this is captured perfectly by the film noir-esque cue, followed immediately by the teacup-style ride vehicles.
But can we just take a step back and truly appreciate this ride's existence? Because it's a miracle it's even here.
Given the film includes several non-Disney characters, heck, while you're at it, get this shot printed on canvas and hanging on your wall, you can imagine the literal sea of red tape they needed to swim through just to release it on home video. But to build the ride while Spielberg was still under contract with Universal took nothing short of divine intervention.
Plus, we all know what they did with his rides there.
You see why I'm a little uneasy?
Now, I don't think they'll close this anytime soon, but like most every attraction here, it has multiple levels of appeal. For kids, it's a fun spinning ride with just the right amount of thrill they can enjoy. All without ever seeing the movie, those Philistines.
They're children.
They should have that knowledge at birth!
But if you're anything like me and you grew up with this movie, this is the closest we're ever getting to a sequel to that classic. Well, besides the shorts.
I still can't believe I never gave this a fair shot last time. Even when I legitimately liked it. Well, I've made up for this mistake. Why stop now?
I'm sorry I'm too fat for you. I'm sorry you exist.
I'm sorry I ripped you off and sang Skipper Dan.
I'm sorry I have to eat you.
I'm sorry I'm poor.
I'm sorry I like VidCon more.
I'm sorry Michael Jackson is no longer inside of you. Wait. I'm sorry Michael Jackson is no longer inside of you. Nailed it.
I'm sorry you suck.
I'm sorry I didn't put you on the list.
Yet.
I'm sorry you had to endure that video. No, I'm not. It turned out pretty well, actually. But if you also like this video, go ahead and click the like button down below, leave some comments, and if you want a continuous list, you can go ahead and click the smiling Benny the Cab right there to subscribe to the channel. If you missed the last one, it is up in the top left corner, represented by the pen for the attraction. Next one will be up next week, fingers crossed. And if you'd like to catch up with the entire playlist so far, I've left a link down in the description. Go ahead and kill some time that way. But if you want to support us with more than just your subscription and like and comments, you may also do so monetarily through Patreon. Any amount will do. Cancel anytime. Entirely up to you. I'm still going to be making these videos regardless. Anyway, we are going to be going to VidCon pretty soon, so if you're there this weekend, see you there. If not, well, videos. It's always an option. Okay, bye.
Don't ever say skip again.
What'd he say?
He said, don't ever say Skipper Dan again.
Cut. What's that? We got it.
That's a wrap.